For the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee. Thy reward shall return upon thine own head. For as ye have drunk upon my holy mountain, so shall all the heathen drink continually. Yea, they shall drink, and they shall swallow down, and they shall be as though they had not been. But upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions.
It is important, strangers, that you understand your family tree. In addition, what does your bloodline say about you? The Israelite bloodline is a royal family the Most High chose to bear his name.
But thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself, above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
The descendants of slaves scattered throughout the four corners of this earth are Israelites, as well as the remaining tribes living in Africa. Regardless of how the heathens feel about the people the Most High have chosen, Yah is not going to change his mind. The Most High's ways are not like men's ways. The Most High will choose the humble to show himself strong through. The Most High will never associate himself with the proud. Many heathens are prideful. That is why they refuse to accept that the Israelites are black. Most heathens and the strangers who proclaim to love the Elohim of Israel would not worship nor submit to the Most High if he is black. That is why they paint his image into their likeness. The heathens cannot do anything to change the love Yah have towards his people, the Israelites, nor could the heathens change the Most High's mind.
For I am the Lord, I change not. Therefore ye sons of Jacob are not consumed.
The heathens are willing to sacrifice their bloodline to steal what they can never have, the Israelite heritage. You can manipulate history and the scriptures. You will never be the Israelites. Due to their jealousy, Satan was able to use the heathens to manipulate the world. Satan was able to create his own chosen people, deceive the world through his chosen group of people, and gave his people a new name. The kingdom of darkness helped the heathen steal the identity of the Israelites. The heathens who have done this shameful act believe the Most High would support them, simply because the Most High have yet to judge them for their wickedness. What the heathens do not realize, you are fulfilling scripture. The Most High prophesied from the beginning that the nations would conspire together to cut off the Israelite bloodline and that the Israelite name will no longer be in remembrance.
They have said, come. And let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
Strangers, it is your people who have conspired against the Israelites. Everyone replaced the Israelites with the Jews. They associate Jew with the Most High's chosen people. Whenever you hear the people refer to the chosen people, they call them Jew. Everyone, until the awakening, did not even know of the Israelites. Most people believe the Israelites are a group of people that vanished. Some people believe through religion that the Most High has cast out the Israelites and forged a new covenant with all people.
God hath not cast away his people which he foreknew. Wot ye not what the scripture saith of Elias, how he maketh intercession to God against Israel, saying,
religion has done a number on the people of today. It is time that everyone come out of religion. The world believed the northern kingdom of Israel is lost. When I hear people say the northern kingdom is lost, I laugh. How can this be? Somehow the Jews everyone associates as the chosen people have supposedly returned to Israel, yet over 90% of the so-called Jews are missing. The prophecy stated otherwise. The Jews of today can tell you where they come from, who their ancestors are. Somehow they do not know where the other 10 tribes are. Make it make sense. The Most High said he would gather his people, all of the Israelites, not just one tribe, but the remnant of his people that have returned to serve him, the descendants of Jacob. Yah would gather and place the Israelites back on the land he promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Behold, I will bring them from the north country, and gather them from the coasts of the earth, and with them the blind and the lame, the woman with child, and her that travaileth with child together. A great company shall return thither. They shall come with weeping, and with supplications will I lead them. I will cause them to walk by the rivers of waters in a straight way, wherein they shall not stumble. For I am a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. And I will bring again the captivity of my people of Israel, and they shall build the waste cities and inhabit them, and they shall plant vineyards and drink the wine thereof. They shall also make gardens and eat the fruit of them. And I will plant them upon their land, and they shall no more be pulled up out of their land which I have given them, saith the Lord thy God.
The chosen people are not going to continue to be scattered all over the world. In addition, none of the Israelites will remain lost after the gathering. Nobody would oppress his people and there would be peace in the land. Today I see the exact opposite. Whenever you see the opposite of what Yah said, Satan is behind the scene interfering to deceive the world. The creator of everything knows exactly who his people are and where he placed them. The Most High have a connection with his people through his Holy Spirit. That is why the Most High say to worship him in spirit and in truth.
God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Israelites, this is what it means to worship in the spirit. The Most High know where he placed every single Israelite in this world. He placed his spirit in his people to stay connected to him. Through that connection, you can communicate, worship, and the Most High will provide for his people. You do not need an assembly to worship nor to speak to your Father. You can go to the Elohim of Israel directly through prayer and make your petition known. That is how you worship in the spirit. The strangers who cleave to the Israelites and sincerely serve the Most High will be connected to the Most High. Remember, the Most High is a spirit. We are also spirit, house in human flesh. Since the Most High Spirit live in us, we can worship and connect via the Holy Spirit. You do not need religion to do that for you. Because we have the Holy Spirit, the Northern Kingdom of Israel could never be lost, regardless if the Israelites lost their identity. True Israelites carry around a heavy burden of something is missing and something is not adding up. Once the Most High wake him or her out of their slumber, that individual find the missing pieces. The Holy Spirit placed that missing feeling in you, Israelites, to get you to seek the Most High. Once you reach the spiritual maturity to handle the truth, the Most High will wake you up. The scriptures reveal to us that the Most High is hiding his people. Now that the prophesied awakening is happening, the Israelites are exposing themselves.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones.
Through the awakening, Israelites are speaking up and identifying themselves. Remember, Israelites, you do not need the other nation's acknowledgement to confirm your Israelite heritage. The Holy Spirit giving you the absolute assurance is all the confirmation you need. In addition, the Most High's perfect peace that surpasses all understanding. Do not rely on the heathens for answers. Strangers, not only did your ancestors blot out the Israelites' name from remembrance, the scriptures revealed the bloodline or the nations who conspire against his people.
For they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee. The tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites of Moab and the Hagarenes, Gebal and Ammon and Amalek, the Philistines with the inhabitants of Tyre. Assur also is joined with them. They have helped the children of Lot, Selah.
Strangers, you descend from the nations who conspire against the Israelites. Your people continue to oppress and living off the spoils stolen from the Israelites until this day. All heathen nations are benefiting off the backs of the Israelites. Your people refuse to repent and take responsibility for their actions. Through their stubbornness, they have put themselves in a position to be judged by the Most High. Religion made your people and nation believe they are on the narrow road that leads to eternal life. By now, you should know that is false. Due to your nation's wickedness towards the Israelites, one of your many punishments, those who are first will become last, and those who are last will be first.
So the last shall be first, and the first last. For many be called, but few chosen.
The Israelites are at the bottom, and all nations of people in this present society is ahead of the original people in every continent of this world. Due to your ancestors' iniquity oppressing the Israelites, another consequence is that the sincere strangers will become servants in the coming kingdom. The wicked of your people will meet their fate in the lake of fire with their god Satan. Many strangers believe that because they had nothing to do with the sins of their fathers, they are not guilty. This is where Satan deceived many sincere strangers. In order for you to recover and draw near to the Most High, you must repent. You must confess the iniquity. Strangers, your ancestors' iniquity, in the Most High's perspective, is your iniquity. That is why it is important to repent. The Elohim of Israel is not the passive deity you learn about in religion. Yah will pass on the sins of the fathers to their children, to the third and fourth generation of those who hate him.
And the Lord passed by before him and proclaimed, the Lord God, merciful and gracious, long-suffering, and abundant in goodness and truth, keeping mercy for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, and that will by no means clear the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children, and upon the children's children, unto the third and to the fourth generation.
If you are an unrepented heathen, the sins your ancestors have committed transfers to you. Strangers, you are not exempt from the sins of your fathers. By the way, your ancestors until this day have yet to be held accountable. I am an Israelite. I was not present when my ancestors chose to disobey the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. I was not there when they fell into idolatry. I was not there when they repeatedly chose to turn their backs on the Most High. Due to their iniquity, I was born in the land that my ancestors have not known, living in bondage. The promised land the Most High promised to my forefather Jacob has been seized by your people pretending to be my people, the Israelites. The heathens are treading down Israel just as the scriptures state.
And they shall fall by the edge of the sword, and shall be led away captive into all nations. And Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled.
The Most High did not prophesy that his people would be oppressed for 400 years for fun. If the Most High said this would take place, it will take place. Yah's words will not return to him void. The scriptures must be fulfilled. Through the hatred and jealousy the heathens have towards the Israelites, it led to Satan deceiving the heathens into conspiring against the natural branches. The Israelites are dealing with the consequences of the iniquity of their ancestors, as well as personal sins. Strangers, you will deal with the wickedness of your ancestors as well. Anyone with eyes can see the mistreatment of the chosen people. Those who do not are in denial. The scriptures reveal to us that the Most High have vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor.
But in a great house there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. If a man therefore purge himself from these, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified, and meet for the master's use, and prepared unto every good work.
Strangers, your nations and people are the vessels of dishonor being used to fulfill the scriptures. When the heathens decided to steal the Israelite culture for themselves, they created a new name to refer to the chosen people. Through the name change, nobody remembered the Israelites. Just as Satan operated through Judas Iscariot to fulfill the betrayal that would take place against Yeshua. Your nations and people allow Satan to work through them to come against the people of the Most High. If the Most High allowed the heathens to oppress his people, Yah has multiple purpose for the pain. Yah is fulfilling what was written about his people concerning their disobedience. Another reason, judgment for the heathens who are not afraid to come against his people. The hatred in the hearts of the heathens have escalated the oppression towards the Israelites. The heathens would lay open the book of the scriptures and paint the image of their likeness. Most people do not know of that scripture because that passage is in the book of Maccabees. The book of Maccabees is one of the many books removed by the council of heathens from the Bible. The heathens have fulfilled that scripture as well. When they bombard the world with an image of a false messiah that looked like them, if you pay attention, Israelites and strangers, the altered scriptures are revealing the truth. You must have the Holy Spirit to find the truth. Without the Holy Spirit, the Bible is a book that contradicts itself. Bloodline is how the Most High operate. It is important, strangers, to know of your bloodline. Everyone wants to claim the Israelite bloodline, but not research his or her own family bloodline. The Moabites, the Amalekites, the Ammonites, the Cushites, the Ishmaelites, and the countless other bloodlines the scriptures speak of did not disappear. Their descendants are present until this day. The synagogue of Satan used race to cover the identity of these nations. Strangers, you should know which of these bloodline you descend. Some of you do not want to accept that bloodline. Most find it easier to believe the fairy tale religion have programmed into your minds. Many heathens proclaim the Edomite bloodline vanished. Esau's descendants are very much present until this day. Israelites, that is not your uncle Esau's descendants. That is a whole hybrid. If this hybrid was your cousin, he would be able to produce offsprings that look like you. Yes, Esau's seed is spoiled, but there are countless of ways to spoil your seed. The serpent seed intermingled with every nation, including the Israelites. Through the Hebrew Israelite religion doctrines, the Israelites are spoiling their seed with the strange woman and men. There would be a remnant of Edomites along with other heathens the Israelites will possess in the coming kingdom.
That they may possess the remnant of Edom and of all the heathen which are called by my name, saith the Lord, that doeth this.
There are countless heathen bloodlines and nations the Most High prophesied against, like the great Babylon. Coming against the Israelites about their culture heritage is out of order. Strangers, it is your responsibility to warn your people. Your role is not to simply cleave to the Israelites and hope for the best. You are to warn your people. In addition, speak up when your nation and the synagogue of Satan is coming against the will of the Most High. Debating whether you will have equal share in the coming kingdom is the least of your worries. You should be happy the Most High is giving you an opportunity. I encourage the strangers to shift your focus to your people. Help them recognize their error. They would listen to you before they give an ear to an Israelite. Now is not the time for you to come against the natural branches. The scriptures warn you not to do that.
Boast not against the branches. But if thou boast, thou bearest not the root, but the root thee.
If you're going to serve the Elohim of Israel, you have to love his people as well. The scripture said a kingdom divided or a household divided will not stand.
And if a kingdom be divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. And if a house be divided against itself, that house cannot stand.
The kingdom of darkness know if they keep the Israelites and strangers fighting, no progress will be made. Do not fall for Satan's tricks. For multiple generations, we have been repeating the same cycle of racism, discrimination, and many other games the kingdom of darkness play. We have to rise above and seek to destroy the enemy at its root. If we continue in the same patterns, we are only repeating the iniquities of our ancestors. The Israelites are not the only people that have been deceived. If you are in religion and continue to stand by organized religion, you are being deceived. The Most High have to renew your minds. The synagogue of Satan will bring all kinds of distractions to keep you off course, Israelites and strangers. The synagogue of Satan is trying to control the narrative by censoring social media. When all of the social media giants band together on one accord with the same mission, you should question the unity and who is truly running these social media sites. The kingdom of darkness is the driving force behind the urgency to silence the people. They want to get the people under control. That is why most people do not know about the YouTube employee calling the cops on a black man for existing. If we, as the people of righteousness, come together and seek our Elohim, no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. Strangers, your bloodline say a lot about you. The school system have failed you. The history you've been taught is all lies. You are not who the synagogue of Satan made you believe you are. Knowing your bloodline will remove all the discrimination and the emphasis on the physical appearance. Race is an invention by Satan that focused solely on appearance. It is interesting people do not have a problem on how race is used to divide us. The Most High does nothing based on the outward appearance. The Most High's original creation resemble each other. That is why bloodline is important. Bloodline is what the Most High used to differentiate his creation. When the Israelites were mourning the death of Jacob and they were going to bury Jacob, the Canaanite mistaken the Israelites for their brother Mizraim, as known as the Egyptians.
And when the inhabitants of the land, the Canaanites, saw the mourning in the floor of Atad, they said, "This is a grievous mourning to the Egyptians." Wherefore the name of it was called Abel Mizraim, which is beyond Jordan.
The reason the kingdom of darkness do not want you to focus on your bloodline, it will expose those who do not belong. I encourage everyone to research his or her family's bloodline. Do not rely on the synagogue of Satan and their corrupt DNA corporations to tell you who you are. If you are for the Most High and seeking him for truth, use only his resources and wisdom.
O Lord, my strength and my fortress and my refuge in the day of affliction, the Gentiles shall come unto thee from the ends of the earth and shall say, Surely our fathers have inherited lies, vanity, and things wherein there is no profit. Shall a man make gods unto himself, and they are no gods? Therefore, behold, I will this once cause them to know. I will cause them to know mine hand and my might, and they shall know that my name is the Lord.